come here in a 2017 Ford Focus RS. If you're not familiar with the RS was very popular over in Europe. They brought it over here to the US. Unfortunately, they're gonna stop making it after this 2018 model year. The Focus will still be available in Europe and other areas, but just here in the United States, we're getting rid of it and we're not gonna have the RS anymore. So they made some special editions in red or black that you can get. This one here is the Oxford White. When you're sitting in this, there's really no difference between this and an ST. You still have a lot of the same features. Your gauges that sit in front of you are exactly the same as they would be in any other Focus or any other ST for that matter. The display that you have here with your Sync 3, exactly the same as what you get in your ST. Even the gauges that sit on top of the dash for the turbo and your oil pressure and all that stuff, all the same as what they are in an ST. Once you start looking around the car, you see that there's not a whole lot of changes. You have the same amount of interior space that you would have in a regular Focus. All your controls are set up in the same areas. It looks similar to that of an ST, except this one here is stitched blue. And then once you start to get into the seats, you see a little bit of a difference. These seats here are still Recaro seats, but you have your suede inserts. They hug you a little bit better than what you get on the Recaros in the ST. Even if you go up to an ST3, these seats will hug you better. Right now, these things are holding me in place. I couldn't really move out of place around a track if I wanted to. One of the biggest differences from the inside of this car is the drive modes. You have four selectable drive modes with this car. You have your normal, sport, track, and the one everybody loves, drift. So with your drift mode, what's happening there is it's taking the power and putting the majority of it to the back. If I'm not mistaken, it's a 20-80 split from the front to the rear. So that'll allow you to break it loose. And if anybody's been following Ford, Ken Block, even Von Ginn Jr., you'll notice that Ford has a drift stick for this. It's a plug and play. So you don't have to run a separate line back there. You don't have to run dual calipers. All you do is you set this thing up, plug it into the system, and instead of having to push in the clutch to disengage the rear and rip the e-brake like you do in a drift car, all you have to do is stay on the gas, pull the e-brake, and the computer handles everything else for you. It's pretty crazy to know that they put something like that in a production car and that Ford makes it. So from that aspect, it's pretty sweet. We're gonna go around the outside of the car and check it out for a little bit, and then what do you say we take it for a drive?
Did it all on purpose. Stepped up in the building, make them nervous. But I cuff your bitch cause she lurking. Spilling all these drinks that I purchased. Yeah, something real strange. When they look around, I see real things. If you maggot at your feelings. Cause this is how I'm feeling.
So just normally sitting here driving it, like I say, it feels like an ST. The clutch is a little bit stiffer than what you get in your ST. Shifting feels the same. Steering wheel ride feels the same on initial takeoff. So, like I said, just cruising in it, you don't really feel a difference. Once you get moving, you know, I said earlier that the shifter feels the same. Actually, once you get driving down the road, it feels different. The whole car feels stiffer, even in the steering aspect of it. You can feel it. It feels a little bit heavier, a little bit bulkier. Like I say, with the seats, you're not moving anywhere. You feel the bumps, but you're moving with the car because of how much it snugs you in here. Once you get the seat right, this could be a pretty comfortable daily. I know that we would daily the ST, and it was a good car. Like I say though, that this feels completely different. One thing that's weird in this vehicle is it has Ford's auto start stop, which is really odd in a manual transmission vehicle. Makes you feel like you kill it every time that it goes into that. It definitely sounds different. The exhaust has a really nice sound to it. A little bit of a rasp, but not that annoying in-port refs that some people talk about from time to time. I do know from being in this car previously, when you get on it, you get a bit of a backfire in between shifts, which sounds kind of cool. You hear it more in the back seat than you do up front here. This is my first time actually taking it out on the road. I've had the vehicle driven around the lot and been on test drives, but this is the first real time I've taken it out on the road by myself. So I gotta say, it does drive nice. You can feel that it pulls a little bit more than what you would have with an ST. You don't have the torque steer that you have with the ST, which was one of my biggest problems with the ST. Now, we haven't gotten on it, so who knows once we actually apply the power and put the gas down on the ground as to whether or not we're gonna feel it then. But as of right now, in just normal driving, you don't feel it. Even when I took off into traffic, there was no pull of the steering wheel. But as a daily commuter, this thing would work. You have plenty of room in the back for your groceries. You put kids in the back. Like I said, this is a Focus in every way, shape, and form outside of the fact that this thing is four-wheel drive. Give it a little bit of gas. Okay. Not too bad. Didn't take long to go from 60 to 80. And the power came on smoothly, too. It's not like a slow, gradual, and then you feel the boost kick in. It was, from what I was doing, you could feel the power is gradually coming on. It might have something to do with the four-wheel drive. Most vehicles that I've driven that have been turbocharged have either been front-wheel or rear-wheel drive. Visibility in this car, if you're going to drive it daily, not bad. You can see out your quarter windows. You got your rear windows you can see out. Back windows, not too bad. Side vision's all right. When you turn to your driver's side, though, that pillar that sits right behind you is kind of a blind spot. Ford does have the mini mirrors in the corners of these. I don't believe that these came with the blind spot awareness, or bliss as Ford calls it. So you will have to use those if you're looking to turn that. Otherwise, you got to lean back. With this one here, we still have a window sticker in it, so I can't really see around it all that well. From the outside of the car, you do see some noticeable difference from this and a regular Focus or an ST. Some of the things that really stand out is you have a bigger rear wing in the back. It sits up higher, elevated. You have larger openings in the front for the intercooler. You have the solid black bar that runs across the front with your RS logo. You don't have the center exhaust like you have in an ST. You have dual exhaust coming out of either side of the vehicle. It does have a nice sound to it. I do like the look of the center exhaust, but the sound of this one is far superior to that of the ST. Everything from the headlights up is the same outside of the spoiler. The front fascia is a little bit different, looks a little bit more aerodynamic from that aspect. But other than that, I mean, this car is pretty mean looking for a Focus. So the car does pull pretty good. But when you let off at the top of a gear, that's when you get the and it's kind of cool. It's a little bit importy. Now you might see the camera wobbling around a little bit and me adjusting it. That's because we're on a bit of rough road right now. This is a route I like to take people on if they are driving a sports car. That way they can kind of get a feel of how this is going to be compared to perhaps what they had driven previously. So this bit here is rough. There's some potholes. There's some dips in the road. Of course, as you guys can see with the video, the camera is vibrating around. But it's nothing that's really jarring me to the point where I'm like, oh God, I'm gonna die in this thing. So, not too bad overall. And there goes the camera again. So I'm gonna slow down, bring it to a stop. Now the camera might fall on this because I'm gonna launch it. Yep. Wobble in the steering wheel. It could be the fact that I'm also holding a camera, but it's not bad. Pulling through gears, initially you feel the oomph of the car, but as you start moving, for me anyway, it's kind of like meh. It could be because I'm so used to driving a Mustang and or just V8s in general that I don't really feel that, but I don't know. Got it in sport mode here. Just take off here real quick from a sport mode. Okay, so there is a difference in the sport mode when you get in here. Feels like the power might come on a little bit sooner. So now we're gonna go through some turns here, see how we do with this. Downshift, got a little bit of a pop there. Car leans in, but she handles really good through this turn at 60 miles an hour. You can feel the lean, but as it gets deep into the lean, it just kind of stops and stays there and just kind of holds you, which is good. The thing feels good at speed. Downshift into third. Hit this next turn. Again, you feel that lean, but then it bites and holds you in. Not bad, not bad. So, if you're looking for a car, I would say that you want to just be a beast on the highway or at the drag strip, of course there's gonna be stuff you can do this car to make it faster or make it pull harder. This wouldn't be the car for me, but if you want a car that you can take to an autocross, or if you want a car that you can take rally, this would be a great car. Okay, so when you put it into drift mode and then you take off like that, completely different feel. Feels a little bit closer to what you would have out of your EcoBoost Mustangs. Now, I will say this. This thing's got more power than the EcoBoost Mustang. And that's nothing to turn your nose up at, because that Mustang has 315 horsepower, which is about what they had in the 09 to 2010 Mustang GTs. So now you have that coming out of an EcoBoost Mustang four-cylinder, and then with this you have even more. So with this, Ford says that you have 340 horsepower as well as 340 foot-pounds of torque. So that's actually pretty good, and then having all of that come out of an all-wheel drive vehicle is really nice. So I can't complain. It's a fun car. Now the one thing that you're going to hear people talk about the most when it comes to the RS is the price. So with these things, they're stickered at 42. Even now that this one here being a 2017, it's still sticker price. Now when they first came out, a lot of people were charging 5, even 10 over sticker. So it was hard to find a Focus RS under 50. Now, did they sell? Absolutely. But they have to sell to the hardcore, someone who is really looking for that type of vehicle. If you weren't looking for an RS and you weren't a huge fan of the vehicle, if you weren't a person who was specifically really interested in the RS, or been a previous ST owner and you were really psyched about this, you weren't gonna go and drop $50,000, $55,000 on a Focus. I'm telling you right now, I do like this car. I do like it. But even being me, I would find it hard to drop $42,000 on this car. I've seen some of them discounted down to 35. There you're talking, okay? Because after your tax, title, and license, maybe you can get them down a little bit more. When the ST first came out, when we got ours in 2014, after tax, title, and license, everything out the door, we paid 36, which at the time I felt was a lot for a Focus. But it was a good car, it was a fun car. I could see paying that for this. You know, the Focus STs, you can get those anywhere between 19 to 26 now. So I feel that it's just naturally smart for Ford to bring down the price of the RS. Great car. Maybe if it would have been a different price, they could have saved it. However, Ford is getting out of the car game, so who knows where that would have fallen with their plans. Backup camera is standard on this thing now, which is sweet. Once you have a backup camera, you become reliant on that backup camera. I use mine all the time. Okay, so there you have it. That was the 2017 Focus RS. We've taken it out for a drive. It's a great car. I would suggest anybody get it if you can get it in the mid-30s or low-30s. These things used would be absolutely great as long as they have low mileage. Definitely something I would stick with. Okay, so by now you guys know the drill. Like, comment, and subscribe. If you like what you saw today, comment below so I can do more videos like this. If you didn't like it, comment below so I don't do any more videos like this. Let me know what you guys want to see so we can help build this channel for you guys and make everything way better than what it is now. All right, until next time, see you later. Peace.